First off, if you are a sole proprietor or a single member LLC, you are taxed on the profit of your business. Let's talk about what that means. The money you bring in from your launch is your revenue. Then you subtract any costs that it takes to earn that revenue, any operating expenses, any other things. Let's say it's coaching. Let's say it's advertising, apps and software, you know, money that you've spent in order to be able to generate this income, payment processor fees, all that stuff. Those are called business expenses, and those are business expense deductions on your taxes. So what happens is you make a certain amount of money as a business owner, you reduce it by the expenses, and you end up with your profit. That's the net income or the profit. Those are synonymous. Your net income, net of expenses. And here's what if you need a good reference point, net, think of a net that catches and filters things. It's what's left over, right? It's what's left over after you've, you know, let's say you take a net and put it through your pool and you clean it out. Whatever's left over is what's left over. That's your net income. So if that helps you remember, that's what you can remember is your profit, is your net income. So let's think about, okay, we have the net income and you're going to pay taxes on that. Now, here's the thing. If you're a sole proprietor or a single member LLC, you also need to pay your share of self-employment taxes, which is those payroll taxes, those pesky payroll taxes they would take out of your paycheck, which is your Social Security, Medicare. This was all on your pay stub when you were an employee. And if you still are working a full-time job, I encourage you to look at your pay stub and realize how much money is being taken out in taxes from a federal tax withholding, your state, your payroll taxes, which is your Social Security, Medicare, as well as other deductions.